Hey guys, what's up? So this video will be about the introduction to the posterior abdominal wall. So the posterior abdominal wall will extend from the 12th rib up to the pelvic brim. So it extends from the 12th rib all the way up to the pelvic brim, that you need to remember. So the posterior abdominal wall extends from the 12th rib up to the pelvic brim. So it is a strong and stable wall, and because it is constructed by bones, muscles and fascia. It is very strong because of the muscles, bones and fascia covering all of them. That's why this makes a very stable structure as a posterior abdominal wall. So what do we have in the posterior abdominal wall? In terms of bony part, we have the 12th rib, then we have the lumbar vertebra, then we have the iliac crest and iliac fossa. So these forms the bony support for the posterior abdominal wall, that is the 12th rib, lumbar vertebrae, iliac crest and the iliac fossa. So what about the muscular support? It needs to be supported by the muscles, right? So what about the muscular support? So muscular support is mainly by four posterior abdominal wall muscles, and they are the psoas major on the either side. Then we have the quadratus lumborum, then we have the transverse abdominus, and also we have iliacus muscle. So these forms the muscular part of the posterior abdominal wall, which support the posterior abdominal wall, and these forms the bony part. Basically, these all the structures will support the posterior abdominal wall and keep it stable. So what are all the structures that we need to study about the posterior abdominal wall? We will study muscles and fascia of the posterior abdominal wall. Study about the muscles and fascia. Then we will also learn about great vessels of the abdomen, that is the abdominal aorta, as well as inferior vena cava. We'll learn about the major vessels. We'll also learn about the azygous and the hemiazygous veins. Azygous and hemiazygous veins. Then we'll learn about the lymph nodes and lymphatics of the posterior abdominal wall. Lymph nodes and lymphatics of the posterior abdominal wall. And finally, we'll look at the nerves in the posterior abdominal wall. So we are going to study about the muscles and the fascia, the abdominal aorta and the inferior vena cava, azygous and the hemiazygous veins, lymph nodes and the nerves. This is about the lymphatic system, nerve supply, the major arterial supply, major venous drainage, and also muscles and fascia. So basically, this is a clear introduction of the posterior abdominal wall, the bony support, the muscular support, and all the things that we are going to study. So thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe and share it to your other friends.